As I said, customer focusing, service related, higher order service related jobs, technology, what we call STEM subjects, highly skilled. I think other things are quite interesting to think about in terms of buying up the assets of many countries. And that can have profound, both positive and negative interests. And I know Morocco, inward investment, has been a goal for the country for many years, because it creates work, it creates employment, and in many cases it creates good jobs. But there's been some very subtle patterns over the last 10 to 15 years which are important to understand. The multinational corporation is in some sort of retreat. If we look at the measures of multinational companies, their share price, the profits they get from a number of economies, is now that multinationals no longer own as much of the intellectual property as they once did. They can buy it after it's established in the IT sector. They once owned something like 50% of the intellectual property around the world. That figure is in decline. They may buy it up after it's created, but that's different from having the research and innovation dynamism to make it happen. Localization of businesses is growing fast. They employ 2% of the world employees. They manage to have some area in the region 50% of the value of trade scenarios. But it does seem to me to suggest that we can see a fragmentation of business. Leveraging technology effectively to promote individual learning. You will be used to the concept of a school, even perhaps a university, where you listen to lectures, you go to seminars, and you learn what the person at the front determines you should learn. That's traditional, and if you do certain assessments and you're deemed to have passed them, you go away with accreditation. And that model hasn't really shifted for more than a century or more. But I think what we need to think about is a number of things. I think you come from a very different background of education, your expectations, the way you engage with technology is different. And I think gradually universities are now recognising that, their investment in online platforms, virtual learning environments, and also the way that they're structuring their curriculum around that. That curriculum key has to involve you. It's not just about an expert sitting here at the front who has the knowledge that you need to know and do the job. You need to, as part of your personality, this is the way that you think. Universities have a duty to you to change the way the pedagogy works. So making you active learners, making you effective team learners, involving you in curriculum design, involving you in setting you problems and tasks which get you thinking more deeply about the subject, rather than simply learning a body of knowledge in a book which you then give back to me in an assessment. We need to engage you in that learning, to involve you in it, and increasingly you'll see the agenda about personalising that learning journey.